organic, true urban break culture.
This is dBridge representing Exit Records, here to talk about Mosaic and other things. As much as the DJ, I've got these many sides to what it is that I do. Label manager, producer, DJ, whatever, and it's like, I have had to adapt in some senses where, you know, going out there and lugging records about doesn't make sense anymore, sort of thing. It's, you know, the whole advent of the CD and Serato, you know, I've taken them on and I used them to my advantage. You know, I was interested. I think it was Ronnie actually said it. You know, I play music, not a medium. Which is, you know, I thought that's a fair comment. But at the same time, the flip side is I'm also a record collector myself. You know, I love that picking up a record, looking at it, the whole process of putting it on the player. This whole thing, it's been around 2002-2003, where people were starting to see the decline of sales, and it was like, shit, what are we going to do? How can we make money? Okay, well, let's start. We can do this, you know, keep things cheap, put it in a disco bag and fling it out there. No real artwork. And it was kind of like, well, it kind of felt to me like, well, hold on a minute, if anything, now's the time to actually probably spending a bit more money on that and put out a good looking product that people want to keep. Because I kind of base the way I release records in the same way I consume them myself. So when I go record shopping, the things that draw it to me, I'm a sucker for limited editions and all that kind of stuff. So I was always, you know, wanting to, that was something I always wanted to do, which is why I did the whole Aptitude series. But another thing that bugged me as well was when I went to Japan, and those people out there, they know how to catalogue music, and I go out there and I go record shopping and I'm just like, it's drum and bass. It's like, there's no drum and bass. And it was kind of like, suddenly it was almost deemed uncool, and it was like, hold on a minute, when did that happen? And it really freaked me out. So I had this kind of, it was like a personal challenge, it's a personal goal for me. It was like, I want to get my records, you know, back in those kind of stores again, you know, and even, you know, like I said, the style stores, all those kind of things. Shops like Rough Trade weren't stocking it, you know, all the stores that used to stock it weren't really interested in what the record drum and bass anymore. And it was like, well, what is that? And I think one side of that just is the, you know, the presentation of it, you know, obviously the content on there as well. So I've just, you know, alongside Instrumental, with their label, we just kind of like, we have personal like battles between us, like who can come up with the maddest concept. And I think they're winning at the moment with their sleeve. But I think it's important to put together a good product. Music records nowadays we haven't got the sales that we used to have, which is clear. So you have to cater for the MP3 market. I think the average person out there hasn't got access to a record deck, so vinyl is a kind of new format to them. But it's, you know, there's those out there who do love that, and I'm one of them. And I think in terms of my sales as a label, they still account for quite a bit of it. You know, MP3s, they do all right, but I kind of almost sell them because I have to rather than I want to. I don't like the format. For me, it feels like, you know, in 10 years' time, an MP3 that you bought, do you even remember it? Two, it's going to be on some redundant hard drive that you can't remember, that's probably crashed and corrupted and you haven't backed up. So there's no kind of, it's real, it's got this real disposable nature about it, which I don't like. which is why I find I'm still drawn to vinyl, just for that one of the, for those reasons alone. And I like the idea of, you know, in years to come, going through a record shop, flicking through, you know, I'm still in there. It's an important format that, regardless of what happens, technology shouldn't be forgotten.
When I first started Exit, it was very personal, kind of like it was just for me and that was it. But nowadays, because I'm putting out other people's records, I now realise that, you know, I have to try and sell as many copies of someone's tune as I can to kind of, you know, to at the end of, you know, every 6 months be able to give them some money. So to, you know, so that's why I'm kind of had to sort of succumb to the MP3 market. But it's there's some things I'd like to change with it, if possible. I don't like the, with iTunes, the kind of pick and choose mentality that you can have with it. Of, so it kind of takes away the concept of being, of putting on a CD or putting off a vinyl and listening to an album through in its entirety as the artist intended. I don't like the idea of just, you know, shuffle all that kind of. You know, obviously you can have your favourite tracks and such, but as a, just to be able to kind of like, okay, here's that person's album. Well, I only really want that track. So you kind of have to, in some ways, you kind of have to make buying the whole thing a desirable option as well. And also, what we're, you know, the changing nature of the market, which is now with the vinyl, with the album. If you buy the vinyl, there was always that sense that people who buy vinyl kind of lose out because you can't physically put everything on there sometimes. Or, you know, we've got like 21 tracks on this Mosaic CD. It's like, well, being able to put that onto, that's going to be like a 10-piece vinyl, which is, in terms of, you know, cost, is ridiculous. So it's like, well, now what we're doing, Breaks recently done it with his own, Caliber's doing it, is, you know, give the CD with the vinyl, give the CD free with the vinyl. So it's kind of like enticing people to buy that format. And, you know, not as a vinyl punter, them not losing out as such. I'm always looking for new things with the label. I love putting out records. I love putting the artwork together. For me personally, it's like another canvas in terms of, you've got two sides of records and then you've got the artwork as well. It's all of it's just as important as the music. True urban breakbeat culture, organic.
Organic, 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 organic.
True urban breakbeat culture.